Please rise. This woman to be united in marriage to this man.
The mother and I?
May be seated. We gather as a community, family, and friends and feel ripples of excitement and tremors of joy as we celebrate the marriage of Alex and Amber. The world is filled with harmony, soaring birds, roaring ocean, brisk wind, endless sand, each unique, each relationship in harmony with the others. Alex and Amber, you've come here to affirm your love for each other and to enter into this beautiful tapestry of life. Marriage is a gift. Marriage is an opportunity for love to be learned. Marriage is a journey in which we as the travelers are faced with many choices and are responsible for these choices. Marriage is a call to servanthood. Marriage is a call to friendship. Marriage is a call to suffering. Marriage is not an event, but a way of life. Marriage involves intimacy in all areas for it to be fulfilling. Today, Alex and Amber, you come together bringing all of you to this marriage, all of your wonderful parts, all of your hurts and pains. You especially bring today all of your hopes and dreams for this marriage. You both have tremendous faith in each other as you trust your future to the other's care. You have excellent reasons for believing you belong together, but you have no guarantees. Instead, you stand together about to accept on faith the challenge of creating the future together. You promise to be faithful to one another in big things as well as small, and your constant faith in each other will give form and substance to the beautiful hopes you have for your future. Unless you're an unusual couple, at times your marriage won't look anything like the vision you celebrate today. You may not feel much evidence of the love you now feel so keenly. At such a time, remember this moment. Remember the hopes and dreams that have been entrusted to your care. Marriage begins with a leap of faith that says, I will, before an unknown and unknowable future. Marriage is about being full of faith or faithful to one another. Faithfulness respects each other's ideas and feelings, keeps each other's secrets, guards each other's dignity, and honors each other in public and in private. Faithfulness is built from 10,000 minute acts of trust and trustworthiness. In such faith, you'll find the fulfillment of all the hopes and dreams you have today. Alex and Amber, have you come here freely without reservation to join together lawfully in marriage? If so, say, I have. Before family and friends ask you to affirm your vows to each other, as you enter this marriage, begin to share all the joys of this new relationship, whatever your future may hold. Alex, repeat after me. I, Alex.
I, Alex.
Take you, Amber. To be my wedded wife. To have and to hold. From this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as we both shall live. Amber, repeat after me. I, Amber, take you, Alex, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, so long as we both shall live. I have the rings.
Thank you.
These rings are an outward invisible sign of invisible truth which binds two hearts in one. As such, they're the symbols of the enduring and unending quality of the love which is now expressed between Alex and Amber. Amber, this ring I give you is my personal gift, my personal promise of love, trust, and pride that you are my wife. Amber, repeat after me. Alex.
Alex.
This ring I give you is my personal gift.
My personal promise. My personal promise.
Of love, trust, and pride.
Of love.
That you are my husband. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow, tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. 1 Corinthians 13, 4-8 says, love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Please join me for a prayer blessing over their marriage. God in heaven, you ordained marriage for your children and you gave us love. We present you Alex and Amber, who come this day to be married. May the covenant of love they made be blessed with true devotion and spiritual commitment. We thank you for helping them, giving them strength and courage to keep their vows. Thank you for helping them to create for their family a peaceful, stable home of love as a foundation on which they can build their lives. When selfishness shows itself, grant generosity. When mistrust is a temptation, give moral strength. When there's misunderstanding, give patience and gentleness. When suffering becomes a part of their lives, give them a strong faith and abiding love. Amen. Alex and Amber, in the future, happy occasions will come as surely as the morning. Difficult times will come as surely as the night. To say the words love and compassion is easy, but accept that love and compassion are built upon patience and perseverance is not easy. Alex and Amber, as much as you've declared your willingness to end the state of marriage with each other, declare the same in the company of these witnesses. By the virtue of authority vested in me by the state of Florida, I pronounce you husband and wife. It's my pleasure to introduce to you all for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Alex and Amber Baston. Alex, you may kiss your bride.
Achilles and his gold, Achilles and his gold, Spider-Man's control, Batman and his friends. And clearly I don't see myself in the moment, I wish you so much you wanna go. How much you wanna risk, I'm not looking for somebody with some superhuman gifts, some superhero, something to tear your pants.
I'm going to take it from my room.
good friends, my evil twins, and we're going to go have a good time tonight.